Like taxis have high prices, low utilization. There are a lot of times of day where actually both sides would be better if prices were lower. Like taxi drivers would be busier, they'd actually be making more money if prices were lower. More people would get transported because the price would be lower and there'd be more people willing to take taxis, et cetera. And so that's kind of what that lost value is. And I think in retailing it happens quite a bit. I think what happens in retailing is that people tend to post high prices because they take a lot of risk in building products and getting them produced and putting them on the shelf. That high price is often justified by the fact that we don't usually sell everything that we produce and put on the shelf, and therefore we have to recover that kind of excess production cost through the people that actually do buy the product. But if we were a little bit more clever and kind of could customize the price, we could. We could sell both to people that value it a lot and to people that don't value it as much with something closer to like, so it's kind of like what we do at Uber. So like in the peak periods where there are people that value it a lot, we charge for it. In the off-peak periods, that can support lower prices in the off-peak periods. And we get just better coverage of everybody that wants a ride that we can profitably serve. And you can actually generate both higher profits for the firm and also higher profits, higher surplus for consumers. It's not always allocated the same way. Some people end up paying more, some people end up paying less. But in the aggregate, you can create more value for both consumers and retailers.
Today at Orchard Mile, I basically tell my team, we need to stop having first dates with our customers. We need to learn more about them. And you know, Uber was on the forefront of kind of this five-star rating program as well as Rent the Runway, and they're constantly getting these feedback loops. At Orchard Mile, we've created a personalized shopping street where you can basically select the brands you like, the categories of the brands that you like, and basically we're starting to learn explicitly what consumers like that's personal to them, as well as adding on the layer of clickstream data. So at that point, you can start to ask yourself, you know, what is the value set of this consumer, and how does my brand mean more to them? So very much our goal is to create this holy grail, this experiential marketplace, where if I know as you are a consumer and you've never bought this Oscar de la Renta dress before, but you've looked at it six times, I can start to share that data with Oscar de la Renta, and they will actually get their creative team to email you a personal letter saying, by the way, you know, this new woman in Texas, come to our showroom next time you're in New York, and we can show you the new collection, serve you champagne, and really start to cultivate that relationship.